नमस्कार. आत्ताच जाणी 12th स्टँडर्डची एक्झाम दिला असे सगळे भुरगे, त्यांचे पेरेंट्स, टीचर्स आणि जे कोण आमकां या वेबिनाराक जॉईन झाल्यात तांकां सगळ्यांक मायेमोगाचो येवकार दिता. हे वेबिनार म्हळ्यार वॉट आफ्टर HSSCE, बारावे उपरांत कितें, ह्या विशयाचेर आयचे हे वेबिनार आसा. खूब जणांक असो प्रश्न सदांच पडटा की बारावी जाली, बऱ्या मार्कान पास तर जाला, की आतां फुडें कितें करप? आर्ट्स घेवं, सायन्स घेवं, काय कॉमर्सूच बरें पडटलें? बरें, आर्ट्स घेतले जाल्यार तातूंत खंयचो टॉपीक घेवप, खंयचो सब्जेक्ट घेवप? सायन्स घेतल्यार इंजिनियरिंगाक वचूं काय BSc वचूं? अशे तरेचे कैक प्रस्न दर एका भुरग्याच्या मनांत आसा. आनी हेच प्रश्न सुटावे करपा खातीर गोंयचे भोवमानादीक मुखेलमंत्री, जे गोंयचे शिक्षण मंत्री जावन आसात, भोवमानेस्त दोतोर प्रमोद बाब सावंत हांच्या संकल्पनेतल्यान हे वेबिनार हांगा आयोजित जाता. सगळ्या भुरग्यांक आनी खासा करून गांवगिऱ्या वाठारांतल्या भुरग्यांक ह्या विशयाचेर योग्य अशें मार्गदर्शन मेळचें आनी एक लोळलेली वाट चलनासतना कितें तरी वेगळें करपाची एक ध्यास मेळचो आनी एक दिशा मेळची, ह्या दिकेन हे वेबिनाराचें आयोजन केल्लें आसा. हांव परतून एक फावट सगळ्यांक येवकार दिता आनी जांच्या संकल्पनेंतल्यान हे वेबिनार हांगा आमी घडोवन हाडटात ते म्हळ्यार आमचे भोवमानेस्त मुखेलमंत्री दोतोर प्रमोद बाब सावंत हांकां सुरवेक येवकारता आनी तांचे लागीं मागता की तांणी ह्या समयार आपले विचार मांडचे. भोवमानेस्त दोतोर प्रमोद बाब सावंत,
नमस्कार. सगळ्यात पयली सगळ्या म्हज्या युवा मित्र मैत्रिणींचे जे 12वीची एग्जाम पास जाल्या त्या सगळ्यांचे खूब अभिनंदन. आनी जे चुकून थोडेशे भुरगे फेल जाले आसतले तांच्यांनी बी डिप्रेस जावन वयचे न्ही, तांच्याय खातीर वेगवेगळे करियर ऑप्शन्स अवेलेबल आसा, ताची संधी तांच्यांनी घेवची किंवा सप्लिमेंटरी एग्जाम्स आसा तिकाय बसचे. हांव तांच्याय खातीर तुमकां म्हज्यो बेस्ट विशीस. सगळ्यांत पयलीं आयच्या 12वीच्या उपरांत कशा पद्दतीचे करियर ऑप्शन्स अवेलेबल आसा हाज्या खातीर CMO ऑफीस आनी डायरेक्टरेट ऑफ हायर एड्युकेशन हांच्या वतीन आयोजीत केल्ल्या ह्या व्हर्च्युअल प्रोग्रामाक हांव म्हज्या बरोबर हे वेरियस पॅनलिस्ट आसा तांचें स्वागत करता. आमच्या मदीं आसात आयच्या खास कार्यक्रमांक तुमकां मार्गदर्शन करपा खातीर डॉक्टर विठ्ठल तिळवी ऑफ डायरेक्टरेट ऑफ हायर एड्युकेशन. हे तुमकां वेरियस करियर ऑप्शन्स कशे चूज करप गोंयांत, गोंया भायर आनी इन एब्रॉड वेगवेगळीं ऑप्शनां कितें अवेलेबल आसा ताजेर ते मार्गदर्शन करतले. तुम्ही सगळ्यांनी हाचो निश्चितच फायदो घेवचो हे तुमच्या कडेन मागता. दुसरे स्पीकर आसात डॉक्टर महादेव गांवस ऑफ डायरेक्टरेट ऑफ हायर एड्युकेशन. तांचो विशय आसतलो जनरल एड्युकेशनल कोर्सीस आफ्टर HSSC इन गोवा आनी ताजो एडमिशन प्रोसेस कशा पद्दतीन आसा हाजेर ते तुमकां मार्गदर्शन करतले. तिसरी आयची स्पीकर आसा नीता नायक, असिस्टंट डायरेक्टर ऑफ डायरेक्टरेट ऑफ टेक्निकल एड्युकेशन. आमकां वेरियस ऑपॉर्च्युनिटीज इन टेक्निकल एन्ड प्रोफेशनल कोर्सीस पोस्ट HSSC इन गोवा आनी तांचो एडमिशन प्रोसेस कशा पद्दतीन आसता हाजेर गायडलायन्स तांच्या कडल्यान मेळटल्यो. चवथो स्पीकर खास करून पुण्या साकून हांगासर आयला ते आसात डॉक्टर श्री रणजीत कलांगुटकर ऑफ IMS पुणा. नॅशनल कॉम्पिटिटीव एंट्रन्स एग्जाम ह्या वेगवेगळ्यो एग्जामी कशा पद्दतीन आन्सर करपाच्यो आनी वेरियस ऑप्शन्स आफ्टर दीस ही अवेलेबल आसा ताजेर श्री रणजीत कलांगुटकर हे तुमकां सगळ्या जाणांक मार्गदर्शन करतले. म्हाका दिसता फक्त 12th जाल्या उपरांत आर्ट, सायन्स, कॉमर्स, BA, BCOM, BSc आनी MBBS इंजिनियरींग इतकेंच न्ही, तर हाज्या व्यतिरिक्त जायती ऑप्शन्स गोंयांत, इंडियेंत, इन एब्रॉड अवेलेबल आसता. फाटल्याच दिसांनी जेन्ना हांवें चवकशी केली तेन्ना कितलेशेच स्टुडंट फॉर द ग्रेज्युएशन ऑल्सो एब्रॉडाक वतात, शिकतात हें पळोवन म्हाका खूब बरें दिसलें. म्हाकाय अभिमान दिसलो की गोंयचे आमचे भुरगे अशा पद्दतीचे वेरियस कोर्सीस नॉट इन इंडिया बट बिसायड इंडिया इन एब्रॉड ऑल्सो अशा पद्दतीन शिकता हें पळोवन म्हाका खूब खोस भोगता. सगळ्यांचें बरें करियर जावचें म्हणून CMO ऑफीस आनी डायरेक्टरेट ऑफ एड्युकेशन हे ह्या पद्दतीचो वेबिनार ऑर्गनायज केला. हांव परत एकदां म्हज्या बरोबर आसलेल्या सगळ्या पॅनलिस्टांचेंय स्वागत करतां आणि तुम्ही सगळेजण लाईव्ह हो कार्यक्रम पळोवपा खातीर उपस्थित असतात आणि निश्चितच तुमचे पेरेंट्सही तुमच्या बरोबर असा. तुमच्या पेरेंट्स, तुमचे टीचर्स हांच्या बरोबर बसून तुम्ही डिस्कस करतले आणि जो करियर ऑपॉर्च्युनिटीज असा जिथून तुमचा फुडार घडपाचो असा. निश्चितच अशा पद्धतीची वेगवेगळ्या ऑप्शनांचा विचार केल्या उपरांत आम्ही खंयच्या सेक्टरात गेल्या उपरांत आमचो करियर जावपाक शकता. मागीर जॉब असतलो किंवा सेल्फ एम्प्लॉयमेंट असतलो हाज्यानुसार तुम्ही विचार करतले आणि निश्चितच राईट स्टेप घेतले. परत एकदा हांव तुमकां बरे फ्युचर आवडिता, सुयश चिंतिता आणि तुमचा फुडार बरो घडचो इतकेच मागता आणि माझी दोन उतरां सोपयता. देव बरे करू.
देव बरे करू. भोमनेस प्रमोद बाब सावंत, तुमची शिक्षण मळावेली दूरदृष्टी आणि सगळ्या भुरग्यांक योग्य असे मार्गदर्शन मिळचे ही तळमळ ह्या तुमच्या संकल्पनेतल्यान आणि आयोजनातल्यान सगळ्यांक दिश्टी पडटा. परतून एक फावट देव बरे करू. या वेबिनारातले पहिले स्पीकर, पहिले उलोवपी जावन आसात डॉक्टर विठ्ठल तिळवी. स्टेट हायर एड्युकेशन काउन्सिल DHE ते रिप्रेझेंट करतात आणि तांचो आयचो विषय असा करियर ऑप्शन्स आफ्टर HSCE अक्रॉस द स्टेट, नेशन एन द वर्ल्ड. या वेबिनारात DHE रिप्रेझेंटेटिव्स आमकां गोंयांत उपलब्ध आशिल्ले जनरल डिग्री कोर्सीसांची माहिती दितले. तशेंच मॅम नीता गोंयांतल्या टॅक्निकल डिग्री आनी डिप्लोमा कोर्सीस बद्दल उलयतली. तशेंच रणजीत कलंगुटकर सर, जे आमच्या देशात कॉम्पिटिटिव्ह एक्झाम्स असतात वेगवेगळे, त्याच्याबद्दल माहिती दिली पुराय पद्धतीन. आणि एकूणच गोयात उपलब्ध आशिल्ल्या आणि गोयच्या भुरग्यांक भारतात उपलब्ध जावं शकपी अशा सगळ्या करियराच्यो संधी हाचेर उजवाड घालपी असो हो वेबिनार. 12वे उपरांत करियराच्यो कितल्यो संधी उपलब्ध असतात फक्त गोयातच न्हय तर देशात आणि अख्ख्या जगात या विषयाचेर डॉक्टर विठ्ठल तळवी आता उलोप करतले. डॉक्टर विठ्ठल तळवी.
माय डियर स्टुडंट्स, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल कॉंग्रॅच्युलेशन्स, नाव दॅट यू हॅव पास 12th ग्रेड अँड नाव यू आर एम्बार्किंग ऑन अ जर्नी फॉर हायर एज्युकेशन. अँड आय एम व्हेरी व्हेरी सर्टन दॅट विथ कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन अँड विथ डेडिकेशन you will be successful on this journey. Before I give a broad overview of what are the opportunities that are available in Goa, in India, as well as around the world, I want to highlight and point to a question that is often asked. And the question is, how do you choose a college? Where do you take the admission? So whether you take the admission where most of your students go take the admission to that college, or you take an admission where they offer a subject or a discipline which you like the most. And the answer, in my opinion, is you should choose a college where they offer a subject or a discipline which you like the most. And the reason being, if you like something, you will put your heart and soul into that, and then you will be successful, no matter what college or which institutions you take admission in. And so the answer is, decide your subject first and then choose the appropriate college. So coming to the degree programs, broadly we can categorize degree programs into four. One is traditional degree program, where we have BA, BSc, BCom. Then we have engineering, medicine. Then we have professional degree programs such as architecture, pharmacy, music, performing arts. And finally, we have vocational. These are all skill-based degree programs, what we call BVOC. Coming to the traditional degree programs, where, for example, Bachelor of Arts, you have quite a few options you can specialize in. For example, in languages, from Sanskrit to Portuguese, you can specialize in. You have economics, geography, journalism, from political science to education. So you have quite a few options if you opt for Bachelor of Arts, that is BA. For Bachelor of Commerce, that is BCom, you have accounting, management, business studies, and shipping management. And finally, in the traditional degree programs for Bachelor of Science, that is BSc, we have quite a few programs from chemistry, physics, biotechnology, botany to interior design, education and fashion and apparel design. So we have a quite a few options even in traditional degree programs. So we have 37 colleges in Goa which offer some of these combinations in arts, commerce and science. Now we come to the degree programs in engineering, and we have some of the most popular and that are also offered in Goa at the level of Bachelor of Engineering. These are Civil, Electrical and Electronics, Computer Engineering, Electronics and Telecommunication, Mechanical and Information Technology, BE in Information Technology. So we have in total 5 engineering colleges in Goa, and in addition we have NIT Goa campus, IIT Goa and BITS Pilani Goa campus. NIT Goa, IIT Goa, they are housed in the same campus as of GEC, that is Goa Engineering College, while BITS campus is located in Vasco. Now we come to the degree programs in medicine. So we have in allopathy, we have MBBS, dental surgery, and also allied programs that includes bachelor's in physiotherapy, imaging technology, and optometry. So in addition to allopathic medicine, we also have homeopathic medicine and surgery, that is BHMS, and Ayurvedic medicine and surgery, BAMS. So in total, we have 4 medical colleges in Goa, homeopathic medicine and surgery and Ayurvedic medicine and surgery. These are offered by 2 colleges in Shiroda, while MBBS and dental surgery, these programs are offered at the medical colleges located in Bambolim. Now we come to the professional degree programs. Here also we have quite a few options at the bachelor degree level, including education, architecture, pharmacy, fine arts, performing arts provided by the College of Music in vocal and tabla, and we also have performing arts in theater. We also have library and information science, law and design. So in addition to the professional degree programs, we also have business administration, that means degree programs in administration, where you can specialize in financial services, hospitality and culinary education, shipping and logistics, and travel and tourism. In addition to business administration, we also have bachelor's in computer application. Here I want to remind students that some of these programs may be self-financed, that means the tuition fees may be somewhat higher. Finally, we have degree programs in vocation, where these degree programs are all skill-based, and we have options in culinary management and software technology. So here students will be able to get Bachelor of Vocation, that is BVoc. Now all these programs I have mentioned, all these degree programs I have mentioned, they are all affiliated to Goa University, that means they are all recognized by Goa University and they are all available in Goa. Now I want to quickly mention what are the opportunities that students can get outside Goa. If some of the programs, if they are not available in Goa, students can, and if they intend to go outside Goa, these opportunities might be available outside Goa. Here I give only a few institutes and degree programs, and of course there are quite a few options available outside Goa. Here I want to mention a few institutes. These institutes are among the best institutes in India. For example, Indian Institute of Science, which is mostly focused in sciences and engineering. Indian Institute of Science Education and Research, these are called ISERS. There are quite a few ISERS now already in India, and these are focused not just in education, but at the same time, students get quite a good exposure in research. Then we have Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, TIFR. They are focused not just in sciences, but they also have institutes, TIFR, in social sciences. And of course, In addition to these institutes, we have IITs and NITs outside Goa. So there are quite a few options also available outside Goa. In degree programs also, there are few options in aeronautical engineering, biomedical engineering, astrophysics, and many, many more. So if students wish to pursue some programs that are not available in Goa, there will be opportunities that are available outside Goa as well. And finally, I just want to quickly mention about the programs that may be available if they are not available in India, and if students intend to pursue that abroad, that means outside India. There are quite a few options. Here I mention only a few. For example, technological entrepreneurship and management, aerospace engineering, digital culture, earth and space exploration, robotics, human system engineering, neuroscience, and many, many more. So the sky is the limit. So you have quite a few options, not just in India, but abroad also. And of course, these are just a list of few programs that given the time limitation, I could mention here. But you should be able to get a lot of information on website of individual institutes or in general if you do Google search. And one thing before I stop, one thing I want to mention, and especially because some of the students have this question. Now, if they have already chosen a degree program and later on, if they decide that they want to switch over to a different discipline, if they want to switch over to a different subject, whether they can do it. And certainly they can do it. And I have quite a few friends and I know quite a few colleagues who have changed their discipline, changed their subject, not just during the degree program, but even after the degree program. For example, if you do engineering, you can bachelor's in engineering, you can do master's in administration. And so those options are available in India as well as abroad. And here is the contact information. If you would like more information, we would be very happy to talk to you. And I would say, never stop learning. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Tilvi. You gave an excellent overview of all the career options possible in Goa nation and overall the world. Thank you very much for this. Next speaker, we have Dr. Mahadev Gauss, State Higher Education Council, DHE, who is going to speak on degree courses offered in government and aided colleges and their admission process. How does actual admission happens and what all it takes will be covered in his speech. Let's hear it from him, Dr. Mahadev Gauss.
Hello, students. So after your 12th results, I hope everyone must be very anxious and excited to take their admission in our degree programs, in undergraduate degree programs. So today I'm here to brief you about the spectrum of different degree programs which are offered in government and aided colleges, which are the administrative control of Director of Higher Education. So I will just brief you initially about various colleges which are available, which are offering the courses, different spectrum of courses under Director of Higher Education. And also, what are the different opportunities that you have in securing those particular degree programs? So let me take you brief through first of our government colleges which are under the administrative control of Director of Higher Education. So we have almost 8 government colleges. Now, under these 8 government colleges, we have several general degree programs such as BA, BCom, BSc, BVoc. And most of these colleges, as of now, they are well equipped with high qualified faculties as well as highly equipped labs and smart classes as well. Apart from that, apart from these general degree programs, we have Kala Akademi, Goa College of Theatres and Kala Akademi Goa College of Theatre Arts, which offers Bachelor of Performing Arts and Theatres. Then we have a Goa College of Home Science, which offers BSc in Home Science, which is again another popular courses which many of the students seek and aspire to take the admission in this college. Then we have those who are interested in the music. We have a Goa College of Music, which offers a Bachelor of Performing Arts, as well as they offer the foundation course. So anyway, I'll brief them in the later part. So these are the colleges, these are the government colleges, which offers various general degree programs. Now, apart from this, we have almost more than 24 aided colleges, which offers again the various general programs and general degree courses such as BA, BCom, BSc. Then some of them, they offer a Bachelor of Vocational as well. Now, if you just look at these particular colleges, you can refer them through the DHE websites. We have already displayed all the information about all those colleges which are administrative control of Directorate of Higher Education. You can refer to their particular websites. You can refer the different, to their prospectus, and you can refer the different programs and degrees which are offered in their colleges. Now, when it comes to the different, like for example, if you want to take the admission or seek the admission in a Bachelor of Arts. Now, under the arts, you will have several different specializations in terms of psychology, Hindi, geography, history. So similarly, you will have it in the Bachelor of Commerce as well. Similarly, you will have it in the Bachelor of Science as well. You will be able to refer to the different programs and subject combinations referred in individual college. Now, if you look at this, apart from these conventional courses, this multi-faculty college which is there in the Dharbandra, it offers, apart from BA, BCom, BSc, we have BCA and BBA. This is the aided course. So this is Bachelor of Computer Application and Bachelor of Business Administrations. Now, as of now in Goa, these are the only two aided courses which are offered in a multi-faculty college, Dharbandra. Then we have a BA LLB, that is an integrated course. Again, I'll speak more on that in the later part. Now, these are the different degree programs which are offered with the different specializations in the individual college. For example, if the students wants to aspire or seek the admission in Bachelor of Arts. Now, many times the students get confused and they may not know exactly what are the subjects, which are subject combinations which are offered, and what is the specialization that they have to do it for their till their final years. And what is the scope thereafter for doing in the master's or maybe to carry that particular research, to carry their studies in the research part as well. So we have general degree, that is a BA, wherein the students can opt for a different combination such as history, economics, history, English, political science. Similarly, you will have a BA honors. In BA honors, you will have a very specific subjects right from the first year onwards, where you can do it a specialization in a history, political science, psychology, philosophy, Hindi, Marathi. Now, for this, as I mentioned, that you can refer to the different colleges which offers the BA program. You can look out for that particular prospectus of those colleges and can refer what are the different specific honor programs that are offered in those respective colleges. Then we have a BCom, which is a general BCom. Then we have also the BCom honors, where the very specific course which has been offered as a degree programs. So in terms of accounting, then you have a business management, then you have a banking and financial service. Similarly, we have a BSc programs, a general BSc as well as a BSc honors. Now in BSc honors, we have very specific course combination which are very popular, like chemistry, computer science, microbiology. One thing I would like to mention here, that many times in BSc programs, the students try to apply to very specific programs and they just think that these are the only common or popular degree programs or subjects which they have to opt. But there are quite many other subjects also which has got a very wide scope in terms of their higher studies when they want to opt for a master's degree or in the research as well. For example, this physics, mathematics or geology as well. Now, let me come to the dual degree part, which is apart from the conventional degree programs that we offer, they are 3 years programs. Now this dual degree programs, the first one we have is a BA LLB. Now this is a 5-year integrated LLB. Now there is no lateral entry for this. The minimum criteria for this course to seek the admission in this course is that you need to be having a 45% in your 12th standard, irrespective of your stream. So there is a common entrance test to take the admission in the BA LLB. So all the students has to compulsory go through the answer their common entrance test. And for the final selections, the colleges, they take the 70% of your higher secondary marks and 30% is taken from the common entrance test. Now there are two colleges which are offering this BA LLB. One is VM Salgaonkar College in Miramar, and next one is VVM Govind Ramnath Kare College Law in Margao. So in a bracket, what I've mentioned here is that intake capacity, as I mentioned, the common entrance test is mandatory for taking admission in these colleges. The next dual degree we are offering is the BA B.Ed and B.Sc B.Ed. For the last few years, this course again has been very popular among the students. Wherein these courses are 4 years integrated courses. So we have a BA B.Ed and B.Sc B.Ed. Many times students after passing their graduation in BA or B.Sc, they seek the admission in the B.Ed courses. So now the students have an opportunity to take the integrated program where the BA and the graduation, undergraduation as well as the B.Ed will be, the degree will be awarded in that one course itself. So that is what why we call it as an integrated program. So we have a BA B.Ed offered in two different colleges. One is a Harmal Pasekar College. Another one is the Vidya Prabodhini College in Porvorim. The next we have is a B.Sc B.Ed. Again, for this B.Sc B.Ed, you need to have your 12th standard passed in B.Sc program. This is offered again in Harmal Pasekar College. So for BA B.Ed, you have 50 capacity each for each of this particular course in each of the college. And similarly for B.Sc B.Ed, we have a 50 intake for each year. Then the next one we have is the Bachelor of Performing Arts. And again, why I specifically thought of explaining you all about this particular is that this is also many of the students, many a times the students have an interest in taking the admission in a music, maybe in the in terms of a tabla, vocal or a harmonium. So the Goa College of Music, it offers three different courses in a BPA, that is a Bachelor of Performing Arts. One first one is tabla, then you have harmonium and then you have a vocal. Now similarly, if the students who has just passed 10th standard and it still wants to take the admission in the music, so they have something called a foundation courses. So they can seek the admission after the 10th standard itself. So again, there are three courses. They are called as a foundation courses. One is a tabla, vocal, and then harmonium. So once they complete this foundation course for the 2 years, the later they can continue as a Bachelor of Performing Arts in our degree programs. Now, this is apart from these 8 courses which are offered in a various college under the DHE, there are also some of the programs and degree programs which are offered as a self-finance programs. Now, the students have to understand that the 8 difference between 8 courses and self-program is that in terms of a fees, the self-finance programs has got the tuition fees a bit on a higher side compared to that of the 8 colleges. Now, these are some of the very popular aided self-finance courses which are offered across the different colleges in the state. That is BA in Mass Communication, BA in BSc in Biotechnology, BBA in Tourism and Travel, then Integrated Master of Commerce, which is a 4 years course. Then again, we have a Bachelor of Business Administration that is very specific in financial services. So the students can refer to all these self-finance courses offered by the respective college. But the admission, the important thing is that admission is not undertaken by the DHE, but the individual respective college undertakes this process. So students have to directly approach this respective college to take the admission in a self-finance courses. Now, to take this particular process, in last year in 2020, during the pandemic period, Director of Higher Education took the initiative of digitizing and integrating all the academic process across the colleges and one common digital platform. So we started off with the pilot project as an integrated academic management system. So the initial first task was to have the online admission process and whether we make the provision for the students to complete the admission process, including the paying of the online fees. And then having the subsequent access to the to their regular class activities, lecture activities, their attendance. So we incorporated academic and teaching learning process and also the student management. Now let me brief you through what is the process that we follow or the students has to follow if they like to seek admission in these 8 colleges or the government colleges which are under the Directorate of Higher Education. So the advantage of having this online admission process, what we are offering right now is that we have almost 15 courses which are offered across the different colleges. Unlike the earlier, before the online process, where the student had to go and physically buy the prospectus. So right now, all the prospectus across the different 8 colleges, including government colleges, the prospectus is free. Students can apply for multiple colleges rather than having just a single college. I mean, they can apply for multiple colleges. They can also apply for the multiple courses wherever they are eligible to apply for. We have more than, we have three dual degree courses, BA LLB, then BA BEd and BSc BEd. Students can complete the admission process by paying the online fees through the same portal. More importantly, we don't charge the students for any of the application processing. It's completely zero application fees. And students have more than 35 colleges to choose from. Usually, the convention students used to apply to the college which is normally nearby to their hometowns. But now, having this the spectrum of courses offered in the different colleges, students can choose whatever the specialization they would like to do it in their undergraduate program. They can apply into different courses in the different colleges. And more importantly, we have a very easy cancellation process itself. There is no hurdle for students if they opt to take the admission in some other colleges or outside a Goa or any other professional college. So it's a very simple process. Start from the admission till in case if you want to opt out of the admission process as well. Now here is the admission portal. The URL is already available on the Directorate of Higher Education website. Students can refer to this particular website and can apply online. The portal is open since 20th of this month, 20th of July. It is open till 3rd of August because we have learned that the CBSE and ICSE boards results are not yet out. So we'll provide this opportunity for those students as well to apply. So the date has been extended till 3rd of August 2021. The process is very simple for the student can apply online and can generate the application form. Now the advantage here is that, as I said, that student has a choice to make about the different courses. So the students can add three different preferences, out of which two are mandatory, one is optional. Student can choose a different programs in a different college, or student can choose a single different degree programs in the same college as well. So once they add these preferences, the colleges will scrutinize their documents. Very importantly, the admission is not done on the first come first basis. So every college will follow the fair and transparent practice to prepare the final merit list. And once the final merit list is prepared, the students will be intimated either through the email, or the merit list will be displayed on the respective college website. So having said this, in case if any one of you all feel like that you need to have a special counseling or need to have any grievances, would like to know about the different courses or combinations while selecting this particular colleges or applying online in these colleges, you be welcome to help you out. You can reach out to this particular address. We'll brief you and we'll guide you to take the admission in these 88 colleges under the Directorate of Higher Education. Thank you.
Next, we have Ma'am Neeta Naik, who is representing Directorate of Technical Education. She is Assistant Director and Member Secretary for State Level Admission Committee for Professional Degree and Diploma Courses. She is going to cover technical and professional education courses and admission processes in Goa. Ma'am Neeta.
Hello, students. Today, I'm going to guide you all through the various institutes for professional degree and diploma courses in the state of Goa. First of all, I will start with the degree courses and then we can move on to the diploma courses. Now, if you see, based on the entrance exams, we can broadly divide the courses into three groups. One is the NEET-based courses. Second is the GSET-based courses. And third is the NATA-based course. NEET-based courses are those wherein you are studying PCB at your 12th and you have to compulsorily answer NEET examination. At the moment, the NEET registration site is open, which you can see it is open till the 6th of August. So any of you all who are aspiring to do NEET-based courses, you have to answer the NEET-based examination. For the GSET based courses, which is for engineering and pharmacy, 23rd of July was the last day to enroll. Coming to the NATA based course, which is actually only for architecture, that is for Goa College of Architecture, already two exams have been conducted. So all those of you who have answered these two tests and have 12 science are eligible for the architecture course at Goa College of Architecture. Now here I am first telling you all about all the need-based courses and the various respective institutions at which you all can avail them. We start with MBBS, which is medical, available at the Goa Medical College. Then we have the dental, BDS, which is available at the Goa Dental College, Bambolim. Then we have BHMS, which is also called as homeopathy, which is at Sri Kamakshi Devi Homeopathy Medical College and Research Hospital, Shiroda. Then we have BAMS, which is also Ayurveda at Gomantak Ayurveda Mahavidyalaya and Research Center, Shiroda. Coming to veterinary, we have certain amounts of seats which are reserved for the students of Goa in two colleges in Maharashtra and one college in Pondicherry. The other need-based courses are BSc Nursing. In BSc Nursing, we have two institutes. One, which is at Bambolim, which is a government institute, and the other one is at Kolwale, that is Vrindavan Institute of Nursing Education. Under Goa Medical College, we have five allied health science courses available as listed below. Under AHS, that is Allied Health Sciences, we have five different courses: Bachelor of Physiotherapy, Bachelor of Occupational Therapy, Bachelor of Optometry, BSc in Medical Imaging Technology, BSc in Anesthesia Technology. Now this chart shows you all the various intakes at the need-based institution, the eligibility cutoff based on 12th standard PCB marks, and the entrance exam cutoff. As you can see in this table, for MBBS, BDS, homeopathy, Ayurveda, and veterinary, all have a cutoff of 50% at 12th standard, and 40, that is for the general category, and 40% for the reserve category. Now, when I say 12th standard cutoff, it means that you should have PCB as 50% for the general category and PCB as 40% for the reserve category. When it comes to the entrance exam, which is NEET, there also you need to have 50% for the general category and 40% for the reserve category. These courses are also need-based courses, that is BSc in Nursing. Now, these courses have a cutoff at 12th standard, which means you have PCB to be 45% for the general category and 40% for the reserve category, but there is no cutoff for NEET entrance examination, which means that it is enough that you have appeared for the NEET entrance exam. There is no minimum marks that you need to score there. The eligibility is based on the fact that you have PCB cutoff and you have answered NEET, but no minimum marks. Same is for allied health courses. You need to have your 12th standard cutoff, but no minimum marks scored for NEET examination. Now we are going to the GSET based courses. Broadly, there is engineering and pharmacy. Both these courses, to apply for both these courses, you have to answer GCET. For engineering, we have five institutes. One, the first one, that is Goa College of Engineering, is the government institute. Others are private institutes: Padre Kossessa College of Engineering at Verna, Don Bosco College of Engineering at Fathorda, Sri Rajeshwar Institute of Engineering and Information Technology at Shiroda, Agnel Institute of Technology and Design at Asigaon. In pharmacy also, we have two institutes: Goa College of Pharmacy, which is at Panaji, which is a government college. And the other one is a private institute, P.S. Rajaram and Tarabai Bandekar College of Pharmacy at Pharmagudi. Here you can see again the distribution seat-wise, which courses are offered at the various engineering institutes. At GC, we have electronics, information technology, computer, electrical and electronics, mechanical and civil, all these courses have a duration of 4 years. Basically, all of them have an intake of 75. Some additional seats will be there in form of TFW and EWS. Again, here we have a 12th standard cutoff, but here the subjects concern are physics, maths, and your third best subject. When I say physics, maths and the third best subject, it means that it could be biochemistry, computer science or information practices. But your physics, maths and the third subject together, it should make a 45% for general category. Similarly, the same group has to combine physics, maths and your third best subject for reserve category and you should have a 40%. As you come to the entrance exam, there is no cutoff. And for the purpose of merit, we take physics and maths for engineering. The merit list is prepared based on the marks scored at GCT exam for physics and maths. And your eligibility depends upon the marks scored at 12th standard. So your ranking which is there will depend upon your PM score at GCT examination. And there is no cutoff score, which means you have to answer the exam and you could have scored anywhere between, see, it is a combination of two subjects, addition of two subject marks, each having 75 marks each, which means there is 150 marks that you have to score out of. And you have scored anywhere between 0 and 150, you are eligible. Coming to the remaining institutions, Don Bosco has four engineering streams, electronics and telecommunication, computer engineering, mechanical engineering and civil engineering. All similar, as I said, intake of 40, similar eligibility criteria. Everybody has the same eligibility criteria and no cutoff for the GCT examination. Then we have Rayeshwar, RIIT, offering us electronics and telecommunication, information technology, computer and mechanical. At AITD, we have electronics and communication, computer engineering and mechanical. These are the institutes which, the next slide here shows us the institutes for pharmacy. We have two institutes, that is BPharm at GCP and BPharm at PS College, having a duration of 4 years. Here the eligibility criteria is that you have to pass. So it is the same for general, it is the same for the reserve category. You have to pass 12th. And again, you have to appear for pharmacy compulsorily for physics and chemistry. You cannot be answering physics and maths and thinking that you can get admission for pharmacy. For pharmacy, you need to answer physics and chemistry. Here also, there is no cutoff. You but need to answer. You can get anything between 0 and 150 marks and you are eligible for pharmacy courses. Coming to architecture, which is only offered at Goa College of Architecture, we have a BArch course of 5 years. The eligibility criteria for 12th is 12th science. Aggregate marks are considered. You have to only pass the examination. So your passing means the criteria is same for the general and the category. And the entrance exam is compulsory, that is NATA. As I've said earlier, already we have finished 2 tests. As of till even last year, the test was of 200 marks and 80 was the cutoff. So this year it will mostly be the same. If there is any change, we will notify it on our DTE website. Coming to the diploma institutes, the various institutes which offer you courses after 10th and 12th standard are listed below. You have government institutions. There are basically 3 government institutions, that is Government Polytechnic Panjim, Government Polytechnic Bicholim and Government Polytechnic Kurcharam. There are 2 aided institutes offering diploma courses, that is Agnel Polytechnic Verna and Institute of Shipbuilding Technology Vasco. Then we have Hotel Management and Catering Technology, which is in private institutions. One is at Kurcharam, that is Guardian Angel Institute of Hotel Management and Catering Technology at Kurcharam. And the other one is at Verna, which is Agnel Institute of Food Craft and Culinary Sciences. Now, presently, the admission for these 2 courses, that is, the admission for Hotel Management course is in progress. So anyone who is desiring to take admission can visit any of these institutes or can come and take their admissions at DTE, that is Directorate of Technical Education, Porvorim. We also have diploma in pharmacy, which is after 12th science, and it is only at Goa College of Pharmacy, Panjim. Here I am listing out the various courses which are available at different polytechnics. Coming to Government Polytechnic Panjim, we have 10 courses, out of which 9 of them are SSC based, which means the entry level point here for all these courses is 10th standard. But for this year, it's going to be 10th standard, plus you will have to answer the entrance exam which is conducted by the Goa Board. It is mandatory for also those students who have answered 10 earlier. That is, suppose you are in your 12th standard today and you want to do diploma based on your 10th standard which you have done 2 years back, it is compulsory that you answer the entrance exam which is conducted by the Goa Board. At Government Polytechnic, we have one course which is HSSC based, 12th standard based, which is Modern Office Practice, where your HSSC could be any, that is, it could be Arts, Science or Commerce. Then we have Agnel Polytechnic Verna, where we have 6 courses. Now, out of the 6 courses, we have 2 courses, that is Civil Engineering and Automobile Engineering, which is a 4-year course. And the remaining 4 courses are 3 years of duration. Here again, eligibility is 10th with entrance exam for all the polytechnics. Then we have Shipbuilding Technology, which is at Vasco. We have 3 courses over here. One course, that is Shipbuilding, has a duration of 4 years. The other 2 have a duration of 3 years. Then we have Government Polytechnic Bicholim, having 4 engineering courses, all of a duration of 3 years. We have Government Polytechnic Kurcharem offering us 3 engineering courses of a duration of 3 years. Coming to the eligibility criteria for diploma courses, for SSC students, students should pass SSC from any recognized board and the entrance exam which is conducted by the Goa Board for admission to first year of diploma courses in engineering. For HSSC, ITI and vocational students, direct second year option is also available, for which no entrance exam is required. But your HSSC has to be science. That means you can't be doing HSSC commerce or arts and wanting to do a direct second year diploma. You have to be HSSC science to get lateral entry or a direct entry to second year of diploma course. Then we have hotel management, for which you could be again any stream of HSCC. For diploma in pharmacy, you have to be HSCC science. It is a D-Pharm course. And lastly, we have modern office practice, for again, you could have any HSCC, that is arts, commerce or science. Now the admission process is very simple. You have basically your documents which you have to get ready. You have to have certain essential documents like your mark sheets, your birth certificate, your passing certificates, leaving certificate, and depending upon your category, you will need to have residence certificate and the category documents, which are all listed in our DT website on the prospectus. Next is the submission of the application form. Many a time students feel that once they have answered the entrance exam, or they have given GCT, they have got the admission. No, the process doesn't stop here. You have to apply for admissions. They feel that, you know, we have answered NEET and therefore we have got a certain score and therefore we are eligible. That is not the case. You have to submit an application form. From the last year, it is the online process and all the details will be specified. This year it's going to start somewhere in August. We'll go up to September or even later. So I request all the students to regularly check the DT website for updates on eligibility list, merit list. Further, as the admission process is going on, there will be a lot of compliance that you need to do in terms of documents. So you have to keep referring to our DT website, the merit list which will be generated, the allotment of seat, the fee payment, reporting to the institution. All these schedules will be put up on the DT website. So I please request you students to refer to our DT website time and again. The schedule of admission process, which is the most important, which we have not yet notified. So we'll be notifying the same shortly. For diploma courses, it will be notified by the 31st of July. For GSET based courses, which is for engineering and pharmacy, we will notify by the 6th of August. And for the NEET-based courses, we will notify by the 16th of September. Now, all these courses, the notifications for all these courses will be there in the newspaper as well as on the DTE website. So I request you all to keep browsing the website on at least not the, a daily basis, then at least once a week, so that you all don't miss out on any notifications.
And lastly, we have with us Shri Ranjit Kalangutkar. He's alumnus IIM Lucknow and he represents IMS Learning Resources. He's going to speak on national competitive exams and courses after HSSCE. Let's hear it from him, Shri Ranjit Kalangutkar.
Hello everybody. I'll be talking about the national level competitive exams that a student after 12th standard can appear for. A country has much more to offer in the education sector. We have about 23 Indian Institute of Technologies, 31 NITs, 20 IIMs, 23 national law universities. The AIMS for medical courses, you have NIFT for fashion technology, you have NIDs for courses in designs, you have Indian Institute of Hotel Management. These are the premier elite institutions that you will find in our country. Almost the top successful people from across all the jobs come out from these elite institutes. So the question here is, how do you get there? What exactly am I supposed to do if I need to do a course or if I need to graduate from these institutions? How do I get the top jobs in the Google and the Amazons of the world? How can I aspire to become the next Sundar Pichai is what I will be talking to you about. So talking about these colleges of national repute that I just mentioned, why should somebody look at getting into these colleges? One, yes, you have a very elite peer group. Lakhs of people appear for these entrance exams. Selected few clear these entrance exams and they will be the best among the country that you will be studying with. The second reason is the state-of-art infrastructure that you'll have. The best faculties, the best library and computer facilities, the best sports infrastructure that you'll find in any of these colleges. And obviously, the most important thing is outcome-based. So talking about doing a course from these colleges, IITs, most of the IIMs are known to offer big salary packages, which could be in lakhs of rupees per month. So jobs is what you get from these jobs with a better and a higher salary packages is what you can aspire for if you think of getting into these colleges of national repute. The first course that I'll be talking to you about is the management course. People who want to get into the board of directors of big corporates, who want to experience the corporate world, yes, this management degree course is something that you need to aspire for. So there are three degrees. The BBA, which is Bachelor's of Business Administration. You have the BMS, which is Bachelor's of Management Studies. And you have the IPM, which is an integrated program in management, which offers a graduation plus an MBA. It's a five-year course. Huge opportunities. When you talk of the finance sector, yes, you have top banks like ICICI, HDFC, you've got investment banks like JP Morgan Chase, you've got Morgan Stanley, Goldman Sachs, and all these big names coming and recruiting you. When it comes to marketing, you've got Nestle, you've got Britannia, you've got Procter & Gamble, you've got Unilever, top companies and top jobs where you can get an entry into. Some premier institutes which offer these courses are IIM Indore, Indian Institute of Management Indore and Rohtak. You've got the NMIMS in Mumbai, which is Narasimha Munji Institute of Management Studies. You've got the Symbiosis in Pune and Shaheed Sukhdev Singh College of Business Studies in Delhi. Generally, we avoid going to places like Delhi, but yes, Delhi has a huge education infrastructure. So definitely something that students should be looking at. You would be surprised to know Shaheed Sukhdev Singh College offers a salary package of about 12 lakh rupees to its 3-year BMS students. So that's big. So these are the prominent exams that a BBA aspirant, a management aspirant, should be looking at. You've got the IPM Indore Aptitude Test, the IPM Rohtak Aptitude Test, the GIPMAT, which is for IIM Jammu. There's NPAT for NMIMS, Symbiosis Entrance Test for Symbiosis in Pune, the DUJAT for the Delhi University colleges and the St. Xavier's in Mumbai. You can go through the details. It will be there on the slide here. Going to the next course is Legal Studies. You want to become the next Ram Jethmalani? Yes, you have to look at top law schools in the country where you can pursue a LLB degree from. The degree that you get here can be a BA LLB. It also could be a BCom LLB or a BSc LLB or a BBA LLB. These colleges give you a lot of options here. Huge opportunity in the legal sector because India is known to always have a scarcity of lawyers. So if you are a good lawyer, yes, you'll have big opportunities. The jobs that you can get into is litigation. You can be a part of top law firms. You can be an in-house counsel of top corporate companies, or you can become a judge, get into the judiciary. Top premier institutes like NLUs, that is the National Law Universities. You've got the GLC Mumbai, where the top lawyers from the country have graduated from. You've got Symbiosis Law School also. So quickly, these are the exams, the CLAT, the ALIT, the SLAT and the Maharashtra Law CET. You can refer to the details. It will always be there on the presentation. Going on to the next course, yes, hotel management coming up in a very big manner because of the booming tourism industry. You get a degree of BSc Hotel and Hospitality Management. The opportunities that you have here, fine. The sector here, most of the hotels is very unstructured, I would say. There is a demand for huge number of professionals who've done proper courses from top colleges in the hotel industry. Also, there is an increase in the domestic and international tourists that you have. And yes, the Ministry of Tourism has done a lot of aggressive promotion to promote tourism in our country. So the IHMs in Delhi, in Mumbai, in Bangalore, the Oberoi Group, right, Manipal are some of the top premier institutes for hotel management that you have. These are again a few premier prominent exams that you can opt for if you want to pursue hotel management. You've got the NCH MCET JEE, which is accepted by most of the IHMs across the country. IHM in Aurangabad has its own entrance test. Symbiosis takes the SET and Oberoi STEP has its own program, which offers a bachelor's degree in tourism from IGNU. Liberal arts is the next course that somebody can opt for. Social sciences, humanities, political sciences, psychology. A lot of options that are available here. You get a degree of BA in liberal arts, BSc in liberal arts. Opportunities available are across advertising, psychology, journalism, social work. Symbiosis in Pune, NMIMS in Bombay, Flame, Ashoka, are some top universities in the country which offer liberal arts programs, and these are the exams that you can opt for if you want to get into the liberal arts courses across the country. The next thing, yes, is government jobs that you can opt for after the 12th standard. Now, these jobs that I'll be talking about are the national level jobs. You get direct jobs after the 12th standard, why should somebody look at this is because probably getting an entry level job after the 12th standard, there is still a chance to reach the top level in the hierarchy with promotions as in what you work in this sector. Respect in the society is obvious. Government jobs have people doing government jobs are generally looked upon. Job security and opportunities for higher learning also. So, talking about these exams, the first one is the National Defense Academy and the NDA and the NA, Naval Academy exam, which is for admissions into Army, Air Force, wings of NDA and the Indian Navy. You've got the UPSC Central Armed Police Force exam, which is generally for getting a job as an assistant commandant in the border security forces, the CRPF, the ITBP, the CISF, and these security forces that you have. You've got the SSC-CHSL, which is the combined higher secondary level exam, which is for jobs like clerk, postal assistants, data entry operators in the government sector. The MTS, which is multitasking staff, for jobs like peon, gardener, daftari, jamadar. You've got the general duty, SSC general duty exam, which is for constables in the BSF and the ITBP and the other border forces that you have. Then you've got the SSC grade C and D stenographer exams. You've got RRB, Railway Recruitment Board, assistant loco pilot, where you're recruited as a locomotive pilot in the Indian Railways. And also you've got the RRB Group D exam for helper, assistant, pointsman jobs, which are there. The next thing that we talk about is study abroad courses that somebody can opt for after 12th standard. So definitely the courses that you pursue in the country, you can look for the same courses abroad. So you have engineering technology, you've got life sciences, medicine, natural sciences, social sciences, arts, humanities, all the options, you can pursue them from premier colleges in the US, in the Canada, in the UK, Australia, and other countries. Why should somebody look at this? One, yes, it is more of a practical based learning, application based curriculum that you have. Advanced technologies and facilities available in those countries, yes, I can get access to that. And somebody wanting to go abroad, pursue a job in the international market, it's an early entry to the international market. So talking about what is the exam, SAT is the exam that you need to opt for undergrad schools in the US, in Canada, in UK, Australia. TOEFL and IELTS is an English language test which you need to appear for, which you need to give, because they test your proficiency in the English language if you have to go to these countries. Also, now I will quickly take up these four careers as well. There is a lot of information available on engineering, medicine, architecture. So I'll just be giving you information on the exams. You've got the JEE main, you've got the JEE advanced exam, which is main exam is used for BTech course from NITs and other institutions, advanced for admissions into the IITs, BITSAT for BITS Pilani, Goa and Hyderabad, VIEEE and the MHTCET for engineering colleges in Maharashtra. Now the eligibility here is 12th pass, but different colleges would have a different eligibility criteria as per their requirements. So you need to check out the websites of those colleges before you apply to any of these colleges through these exams. Medicine has two entrance exams. That's the NEET and the AIIMS, which is for an MBBS and the BDS course from best medical colleges in the country. You've got architecture, which is NATA, which is JEE main, which is JEE advanced. JEE main is for doing a BArch and a bachelor. BArch is bachelors of architecture and BPlan is bachelors of planning from the NITs. And the advanced is if you want to pursue a bachelors of architecture from the IITs. Fashion and design again is a sector where you've got the NID, that's National Institute of Design, which offers a BDES, that's a Bachelor's of Design, and you've got NIFT, that's National Institute of Fashion Technology, which offers a Bachelor's of Design and a Bachelor's of Fashion Technology also. So talking about these courses, students should understand the country has a lot of things to offer, a lot of educational opportunities available in Goa. Yes, we've got IITs, we've got NITs, we've got the BITS and other top colleges in Goa. But you should understand, do not limit yourself to a particular geography. Why should I restrict my chances by just opting for colleges in a particular state or city? Why not also try my hand at the best colleges outside Goa? Fine. So don't be reluctant to move out of your comfort zone. You should actually look for options and good colleges in other states also. And you need to understand that the institutions will not come to you. You will have to go to the best institutions in the country to apply to them. So, quickly talking about who are we, I'm from an institute, IMS Learning Resources, which was established in 1977. We do train students for these competitive, national level competitive exams. We train about 70,000 students every year across the country. Talking about the initiative the Goa government has taken, initiative taken by the Directorate of Higher Education, where IMS, in association with the government of Goa, we share a mission to train students for undergraduate BBA and law entrance exams and postgraduate bank and government entrance exam at a very subsidized nominal fee, so that Goan students also get a chance to explore apply to the best colleges in the country. So these are our details over the screen. You can get in touch with us for any one-on-one counseling required to opt for these courses. Yeah, we are always there to help you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Shri Kalangutkar. On behalf of Chief Minister's Office and Directorate of Higher Education, I thank Dr. Vitthal Tilvi, Dr. Mahadev Gawas, Ma'am Neeta Naik and Shri Ranjit Kalangutkar for their excellent presentation. या वेबिनाराक लागून म्हाका दिसता की जाणी जाणी हे वेबिनार आयकला जिवा किंवा जे 12वीचे भुरगे आतां पास आउट जाल्यात आणि त्यांच्या मनान जे कन्फ्युजन आशिल्ले मात तरी ते पैस जावपाक ह्या वेबिनाराची मदत झाली असतली अशी आस्त बाळगिता. तुमकां योग्य मार्गदर्शन मेळचे, योग्य दिका मेळची आणि एक वेगळी वाट तुम्ही धरून तुमचे एक वेगळे करियर घडून हाडचे आणि तुमच्या जिवितात मुखार एक बरो आदर्श तुम्ही दुसऱ्यां फुडें निर्माण करचो, ह्याच हेतान ह्या वेबिनाराचे आयोजन भोमानेस मुखेलमंत्र्यांच्या संकल्पनेतल्यान हांगा घडोवन हाडिल्ले. देव बरें करूं. तुमकां जाय तेन्ना हे वेबिनार तुमी CMO गोवा यूट्यूब चॅनल तशेंच फेसबूक पेजीचेर पळोवंक शकतात. मुजरत पळयात आणि शेअर करात आणि योग्य मार्गदर्शन जे भोमानेस मुखेलमंत्र्यांच्या संकल्पनेतल्यान तुमकां सगळ्यांक खासा करून गांवगिऱ्या वाठारांतल्या भुरग्यांक हांगा दिला ताजोय तुमी लाभ घेवचो अशी आस्त बाळगिता, अशें तुमच्या लागीं मागता आनी देव बरें करूं म्हणटा. नमस्कार.